Hello, my dear student friends. Welcome back to our channel. This session, we are going to discuss the GATE 2021 Electronics and Communication question paper in that control system. Okay, so control system questions asked in the 2021. Just we do analysis and solution. Okay, so first question is transfer function of the following block diagram is given. Okay. So what will be the transfer function? Okay, so transfer function for the system. So this system, just solution, first solution, right? So first we draw very simple. We draw this diagram in terms of loops. Okay, Mason's gain loop, right? So how many nodes here? 1, 2. 3 and 4. You can have 4 points. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right. Okay. We can have one more. No problem. The gain, no problem. So this is R of S, this is C of S, R of S, C of S. So between here gain is 1. So here is G1, the gain is G1. So here one loop is there. So the feedback loop, which my negative feedback, then forward path is also there. So this is G2. This is having unity gain. Okay, this also have unity gain. Okay, unity gain. So using Mason's gain formula, what is Mason's gain formula? C of S by R of S equal to the forward path PK del K divided by delta. So the K is a number of forward paths. Okay, number of forward paths. How many forward paths here? So P1 equal to G1, P2 equal to G2. This is the two forward paths. This is one forward path. This is another forward path. So then, what is delta 1? Delta equal to delta 1. Delta equal to 1 minus the number of individual loops, sum of individual loops. How many individual loops here? Only one loop, okay, L1. Only one loop, then no non-touching loops. So what is L1 here? So this is the L1. So L1 equal to minus G1 H1. So delta becomes 1 minus of minus G1 H1. Okay, so this is delta. What is delta 1? So delta 1 is, there is no non-touching loop. So delta 1 is 1. Delta 2 is also 1. So what is C of S by R of S? You can easily tell. So C of S, actually, here given is Y of S. So instead of C of S, take Y of S. Nothing wrong. Okay, this is analysis only, right? So C of S by R of S equal to the P1, G1 into 1 plus G2 into 1 divided by 1 plus G1 H1, right? So this is the answer for this question. So what is the answer? G1 plus G2. Answer is Y of S by X of S, okay? Y by X of S equal to G1 plus G2 divided by 1 plus G1 H1. Understand, my dear student friends? Please, if you have any doubt, please post the command. Next question. So the given Nyquist plot is given. So this plot is encircled in the right direction. So the number of encirclement, okay, number of encirclement about minus 10. So it is given g of s h of s as 10 in right hand side of the s plane. So the number of closed loop poles in the right hand side of the s plane is, so how many number of poles in the right hand side of the s plane? Clear? So solution. So what is the solution? Please, my dear student friends, what is the solution? Please do it. So what is the solution? So it is given that GH has 10 in RHS. Okay, so the GH plane has 10 in RHS. Right. So since it is 10, so P equal to 0. Right. So it is from that diagram, it is known that the number of encirclement equal to 1 minus 1 equal to 0. So n equal to p. So p minus n equal to 0. So what is the answer? Hence, no closed loop poles in RHS. So which is the correct answer? Answer A is the correct answer. Next question. A unity feedback system that uses a PI controller is shown in the figure. So the figure. So this is the PI controller. This is the plant. Okay, plant GP. The stability of overall system to be controlled by the tuning the PI control parameter KP and KI. We have to determine KP and KI. The maximum value of K that can be chosen so that to keep overall system is stable, or in worst case marginally stable. So what we can do? We can go for stability analysis. Easiest method is Routh-Hurwitz criterion. So what is given? First find GH, the forward path. So since it is a unity feedback system, so the GH plane equal to this into this, right? KP into S plus KI by S into this. Then find the closed loop transfer function. Okay. Solution. So the forward path transfer function equal to SKP plus KI divided by S into the transfer function GP, right? So S cube plus 4S square plus 5S plus 2. My dear student friends, please do it. So from this, let us find 1 plus GH, the characteristic equation. Okay. So if you simplify this, S into S, S power 4, 4S cube, 5S square, 2S plus 2 into this will be in the system, right? So what is the characteristic equation? So characteristic equation equal to, we can easily tell, right? So the numerator becomes 2 into SKP plus KI divided by S, okay? So S cube, S power 4 plus 4S square plus 5S square, 4S cube, 5S square plus 2S plus SKP plus KI. So this is the, this is the closed loop transfer function. This is the T of S, closed loop transfer function. So the characteristic equation, there is the denominator. Characteristic equation is S power 4 plus 4S cube plus 5S square plus, combine the S term here, so it becomes S2 plus KP plus 2 times ki multiply 2 into this 2 into sorry sorry my dears small mistake so 2 skp plus 2 ki you see here 2 skp then 2 ki so it reflects here s into 2 plus kp plus 2 ki equal to 0 we can form a Routh array Routh table for this Routh table let us form the Routh table then we will come back so then the necessary condition should be kp should be maximum greater than minus 1 you see here if you want say if the system is stable from this characteristic equation the polynomial the sign of the polynomial coefficients should be positive that means what so the ki should be greater than 0 kp should be greater than minus 1 minus 1 kp should be greater than minus 1 ki should be greater than 0 to satisfy stability condition of the characteristic polynomial so characteristic polynomial of this equation should be positive right let's form a Routh array then come back here okay Routh table so what is the x power 4 s cube s square s 1 okay s power 0 so 1 pi 2ki okay 2ki then 4 2 plus 2kp then s square this multiply 20 minus 2 18 minus 2kp divided by 4 this will be 2ki then again if you multiply this please do it so this into this minus this into this so divided by this okay so what do we get s term 18 minus 2kp into 2 plus 2kp 2 plus 2kp divided by the denominator okay 18 minus 2kp understand so this becomes 0 since the one polynomial 1 s power 0 so s power 0 will be 2kp just this into this divided by this we will be having 1 equal to 2ki understand so what is the as per the Routh array's stability criterion this term so the first column elements should not be zero so greater than zero so first condition is 18 minus 2kp by 4 should be greater than zero so what do you get 18 minus 2kp equal to 0 say so kp should be less than 9 kp should be less than 9 so as per this case kp should be greater than minus 1 see as per the Routh array table kp is less than 9 so the what is the range is so the kp range is so minus 1 kp less than 9 okay next case is this as per this k element this also should be greater than 0 this also should be greater than 0 so what happened now we know the kp value right kp 32 kp right So what is there? This into this, this zero, right? So 18 kp, 18 minus 2 kp into 2 plus 2 kp, okay, minus 32 k, minus 32 ki, minus 32 ki equal to, should be greater than zero. So what is here, 32 k greater than zero means, so this multiply this, 36 plus 18 into 36 plus 32 kp, then minus 4 kp square, am I right? So this should be less than 32 ki. So if you solve this, sorry, this is kp and kp. So therefore, 0 less than ki less than 36 plus 32 kp minus 4 kp square divided by 32. Am I right? Suppose if kp is minus 1, k equal to what? Kp is minus 1. Say, let us examine. Let us examine. If kp equal to minus 1, it leads kp equal to minus 1. So here kp equal to minus 1. So minus 32 kp equal to, this becomes minus 4. So minus 32 minus 6. Then k becomes this k, so k leads to 0, right? If kp equal to 9, let us find the value of ki. Please do it, my dear student friends. Even if you kp equal to 9, you see, so 32 into 9, 32, please do it. 32 into 9, okay, 288 minus 36, so 36, 9 square, 81 into 4, so minus 324, right? So 288 plus 36, 288 plus 36, also 324. So when kp equal to 9, in that case, when kp equal to 9, in that case also k is 0. Okay, so the entire zero row will be applicable here. Okay, kp when for the both limits of kp, k becomes 0. Okay, let us find to find the minimum value or maximum value we can differentiate, like we can differentiate the dk gain, proportional gain with respect to the proportional gain, integral gain with respect to get maximum value. We differentiate dki by dkp. Okay, so if we differentiate this expression, so we will be getting around this becomes 0, 32 minus 8 kp, right? So we will be getting dki by dp equal to 0 for maximum. So if you differentiate 36 plus, that is 36 plus 32 kp minus 4 kp square divided by constant, that is removable. So if you differentiate this, you will be getting, so constant 0, kp 1 minus 8. So we will be getting 32 minus 8 kp equal to 0. So kp leads to 4. Okay. So for kp equal to 4, k is the maximum. K is maximum value. Maximum value. All right. That is ki equal to, you just substitute in this expression, 36 plus 32 into 4 minus 4, 4 square divided by 32. So please calculate and tell me the answer, my dear student friends. Okay, so 42, this 36, it will be around 3.13, right? So for kp equal to 4, ki should be less than 3.13 for stability. So what is ki max, maximum value, equal to 3.13. This is the correct answer. Understand, my dear student friends? Okay, so thank you very much.